I took these two devices to an e-waste facility to see what would happen to them. Because, let's face it, there comes a time when even the most reliable HomeLab gear reaches the end of the line. Now, I'm not talking about the 10-year-old machines that HomeLabs are repurposing or selling secondhand or just giving away. I'm talking about the machines that we end up holding on to until there's no other use for them. And let's be honest, we all have that box of just-in-case cables because you never know when you'll need that one impossible-to-find connection. If you're like me, though, it's more than just a single box. I've got bins sorted by connection type and more bins full of random computer parts held on to just in case they might be useful or because I wasn't sure how to responsibly dispose of them. Eventually, I realized I was hanging on to items that I'd never use, like these three PCI Sound Blaster cards. Okay, now I'm dating myself. A pile of old RAM and a random HD home run device that doesn't even work with my current setup, not to mention all of these motherboards that I'll never touch. That's when I decided to find a better way to handle all of this unused tech. A quick search led me to Free Geek Twin Cities, a nonprofit e-waste facility where I could either donate my gear for reuse or have it responsibly recycled. E-waste is a growing problem and getting bigger, with devices constantly becoming obsolete and piling up in landfills. Free Geek Twin Cities addresses this problem by refurbishing tech for the community to use or by responsibly recycling it. I spoke with Kyle, the executive director, to learn more about their approach.
Yeah, Free Geek has been around for about 15 years now. Really started as a small group of people who were just tech enthusiasts wanting to be able to do good in the community by seeing this huge problem that is e-waste. So much of what we use in our day-to-day lives, computers, laptops, they have an end date. They break. Some are fixable, some aren't, but there's not many outlets where folks can one, confidently recycle things or confidently reuse things. So this group of folks just really came together and realized like, hey, this is a need that our community has. Let's do something about it. With all that enthusiasm and energy and just brilliance in that space, it spawned, you know, our thrift store, which is all about tech rescue. So anything that comes in here, that is our ultimate goal, is to get in our thrift store and reuse. And we have a staff of around 15 and a whole bunch more volunteers that come in here every week to test, repair, refurbish, and get things ready to go to get in the hands of folks who need it the most. Our thrift store is really meant to be a place where people can come and afford technology that we need in our day-to-day lives.
Then out of curiosity, I asked him what Free Geek would do with this motherboard that's been gathering dust in my basement.
Like if I brought this in and gave it to Free Geek, like what would happen to this? Like where would it go and where would it may end up?
So I would take a look at this and say, all right, Ben, do you want to help out? What would you do with this?
Yeah.
Kyle brought it to Ben, who runs the build lab, to take a closer look.
This is Ben. Ben leads our modern build lab. So if you got a motherboard like this, what would you do with it first?
So first thing I would look at to see, to quick glance, is I would look at to see if it has USB 3 or not. And USB 3 being these blue ports all over here. So that is roughly my department. Then I would look at the CPU, and this bracket tells me it's an AMD motherboard. So as for specifically, this is an AM3 Plus.
That's right.
So that's roughly, would be my area. So I would have it built into a case. I have several empty cases. So if a volunteer wants to build computers, they can pop this into a case. I have power supplies, pretty much everything there is to build a device. So if you're looking to build one, but don't want to risk $1,000 in hardware, come to Free Geek and we can walk you through the step-by-steps. And if something breaks, I have plenty of motherboards.
After Ben walked me through what they do with a motherboard like mine, he explained that if a donated item fits the modern build category, it goes through a few additional steps to get ready for reuse.
So it's troubleshooting and figure out what may be wrong with the computer. Is it worth fixing? Most of them are just ready to go and just need a refresh of a hard drive wipe and then a new operating system and then they're good to go. But this is a really special place because this is where most of the modern tech, the things that people come in here to buy to get connected, comes through here first before it goes out there and into our thrift store and ready for reuse.
The thrift store at Free Geek Twin Cities is where tech gets a second chance to go back into the community, offering affordable refurbished items that have already been tested by their staff. Whether it's a laptop, desktop, or components to build an upgraded setup, there's quite a variety here. There are some pretty unique finds here too, like these zip drives. Anyone remember those? There's even a whole section just for retro machines known as the beige section.
Anything that falls below the criteria of modern goes to our retro computing that has dedicated to tech rescue of retro computers. So just think of anything beige. It's our beige room.
While I was there, someone actually donated a machine that might end up in the retro section, an Osborne 1. According to Wikipedia, this thing was the first commercially successful portable computer back in 1981. I've never heard of it, but it was cool to see in person. Plus, I doubt that it was truly portable. More like luggable? Right next to the retro section is the Apple department, dedicated to Mac machines. And most of the ones for sale today happen to be retro models.
We have our Mac and Apple department, so anything Mac, Apple from way, way back in the day, Macintosh computers to iPods, iPads, everything new and exciting that Apple comes out, eventually gets here.
I even decided to bring my 2012 Mac Mini to donate. It's the last model that lets you upgrade the RAM and hard drive, and I figured someone else should enjoy it before it's truly obsolete.
There are people who absolutely love every single era of Mac, whether it is super old, brand new, anything in between. What we would do with this is really just assess to see if it turns on, it works, still runs things. If it does, you know, beforehand, everything would be wiped on it. All the data would be removed, reset, and then would go out into our thrift store to be sold in our Mac department to some lucky, lucky person.
The store also has server and networking gear. Some of the stuff is the same stuff you'd find on eBay, but for a lot less. I even spotted a bin full of server rack ears for 50 cents each. That's a great find if you need them. Then there's the AV section packed with amplifiers, tuners, and VCRs.
We also have an audio-visual department, you know, speakers, any media players, VCRs, you name it, anything that played media in any kind of way. We have someone here dedicated and volunteers dedicated to refurbing all of those types of things.
A VCR was actually one of the first things I tinkered with as a kid. We had one with a stuck tape, and I opened it up and fixed it. That's probably where my curiosity for tech started. And they even have a gaming department, too, for both retro and modern gaming consoles and games.
Any sort of gaming goes through there. So we actually got our first two PlayStation 5s that came in.
Wow.
So it's kind of like the timeline. Things need to be out for a couple of years before they start trickling in here.
Then there are things that don't fit into a category, like this orb. It was donated from a museum, and it was used for displaying maps, but the Free Geek team thought it'd be fun to run Mario 64 on it. It's pretty much impossible to play this way unless you have the game memorized. The screen is stretched around the orb, with the center of the display at the top. They even thought it'd be funny to put my Proxmox backup server video in the orb, featuring my big ol' head. Let's just say it hits different on an orb. And speaking of unusual donations, they recently got this custom modified cooler. But not a CPU cooler?
Oh yeah, I think one of them is right up over there. We got a donation of a cooler that on the back, there's a big hole in it. There's a speaker. On the front, there's more holes that were cut into it and has like a CB radio and a car stereo and antennas and all sorts of things. I feel, my guess is it feels very, especially being here in Minnesota, it feels very much like a ice fishing setup. But who knows?
When items can't be repaired or reused for the thrift store, they're sent to the recycling department. Here, everything is broken down into smaller pieces to be recycled or sent to another facility for further processing.
In our recycling room, our volunteers come in, just take apart all the electronics into their component pieces, you know, circuit boards, our PCs, you know, take out the disk drives, take out the RAM, take out the CPUs, take out the power supplies, recycle all the steel. And also, we partner with organizations that make sure that things are recycled locally. It's not other people's problem. It is like if we're creating the e-waste here in the Twin Cities in Minnesota, that we want to be responsible and make sure that everything is being recycled here rather than sent off somewhere else to become someone else's environmental problems.
I get a look at just a fraction of the cord donations, and honestly, it's a bit overwhelming to see how many cords need to be sorted and processed. Kyle also mentioned something they called a Free Geek rental program, where you buy a cable or an item for cheap and eventually donate it back.
As part of, we call it the Free Geek rental program, where a lot of times people will donate things here and then get an upgrade later or find another cord somewhere else and then just comes right back. We just have so many cords here. We always are happy to take more and save your space at home. Use that drawer for something else more useful.
Then
come back and grab the charger for a buck.
Looks like now I have no excuse to hold on to those bins of cords. Can I keep just this one? This place is packed with nostalgia. Stepping in here is like taking a trip down memory lane, no matter how old you are. If it's not the retro computers and electronics, then it's the shelves with old tech books and vintage posters on the wall. It's practically a museum for anyone who loves tech. And if you get a chance to explore the different departments, you'll see rooms filled from wall to wall with tech, all waiting to be tested, rescued, and repaired. Take, for example, this 3D printer getting fixed before it heads out to the thrift store. My trip to Free Geek Twin Cities reminded me of how much potential there is in old tech. It's a great spot for home labbers and tinkerers like us who know that there's always another use for our gear, even if it's giving it a second life with someone else. That's exactly why I brought in these two devices. At Free Geek, whether it's refurbished for the thrift store or broken down in the recycling department, each item is put to good use. They make tech accessible and sustainable, all while keeping e-waste out of the landfills through responsible recycling and reuse. So, if you're holding on to a stash of old cables and spare parts, or searching for affordable refurbished tech, places like Free Geek are a reminder that every piece of gear can still have a place. You should check your area to see if there's a way to donate your items to be reused or responsibly recycled. And if you're ever in the Twin Cities area, you should totally check out Free Geek. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.